Hi, I'm Dr. Mike Evans, and today my question is, what is the best way to treat acne? Acne vulgaris is a scourge of teenagers everywhere. Vulgaris sounds bad, but in fact it's an old word that means common, which acne certainly is. Acne is fascinating in the pantheon of diseases. Many of us trivialize it as simply part of teenage life that fades and really doesn't have any health consequences. But what if I framed it in a different way? Acne is a disease that makes people feel bad, often very bad, about themselves, just when it's most critical that they feel good about themselves. It's a disease that can scar for life, but that could have been prevented. A disease that research shows is as damaging to quality of life as chronic distressing conditions such as asthma, epilepsy, or diabetes. And the timing is so unfortunate. Just as we start to be more aware of our appearance, the oil geysers that are located in our upper chest, back, neck, and face, all highly visible areas, begin pumping out skin grease. Adults can get acne, about 10% still have it at 25, but almost all teenagers do get acne, with 1 in 5 having a more severe case. It tends to come on earlier in women, but the dudes get it a little bit worse. Unlike most acne resources on the internet, I'm not going to offer you a 100% cure. There really is no cure for acne. Most of the therapies I'm going to discuss have about a 40 to 70% success rate. Getting to a higher success rate really depends on you finding your own special recipe that often requires you to combine different agents, what we call step-up therapy. Okay, the first piece of advice is to talk to your doctor about it. Repeat after me. My doctor has seen more embarrassing things than whatever I show him or her. So bring acne up and go back if your treatment isn't working. Now, I bet I can guess the current approach some of you are taking who are suffering from acne. Perhaps you wash your skin vigorously to keep blackheads to a minimum. Maybe you put pimple cream on whenever you have an outbreak. And you might even avoid certain foods that you think worsen your acne. Well, actually, the black in blackheads is really just melanin and oxidized lipids, not dirt. So cleaning vigorously or picking can actually inflame pimples. Washing once daily with a mild soap or soapless cleanser is fine. Putting pimple cream on your existing acne doesn't actually make much of a difference. A key learning is that when you're treating acne, you are actually not doing much for the current pimple, you're preventing the next round. So if you are applying a cream, it needs to go on where you get pimples. For most people, this is in what we call the T-zone. It takes 6 to 8 weeks and sometimes longer to see if acne treatment is working. Now, diet and acne is interesting. Most research shows no connection, but the trial quality is generally poor. For example, studies trying to provoke acne with large amounts of chocolate didn't show effect, but the trials were too short and too small to be definitive. A small trial using a low glycemic diet showed some improvement, but I'd say there's not enough evidence at this time to recommend one way of eating over another. The answer is likely just eating healthily, and if a patient finds a big difference with the food, I say, eat less of that food. Now, to understand the best treatments for acne, we need to start with a biology lesson, then a mirror test, then step-up therapy. I think if you comprehend the biology of acne, it makes treatment a lot easier to understand. When you hit puberty, many things happen, but two things in particular to your skin. First, we get more plugging. This is because the hormonal changes of puberty cause more oil production, what we call sebum, and the surface of the skin becomes a bit more crusty, what we call keratinization. The second thing that happens is we get more inflammation. This is mostly because of a bacteria that colonizes our skin called P. acnes. The P. acnes mixes with the sebum and oil and causes an inflammatory reaction which gives redness and swelling. Now, acne confuses us, I think, because there are so many treatments. One review indicated 140 different treatments and 250 combos. So we can't cover them all, but we can ask what the clinical research says is the most effective of all these treatments. And I think it follows our biology lesson. It's developing a strategy to A, reduce plugging, and B, minimize inflammation. The gist of acne treatment is to start with one therapy. If it works, great. If it only works partially or not at all, then you need to step up to the next level by changing or adding a therapy. Okay, let's take a bit of a detour and do a topicals 101. Topicals are medicines that you apply to your skin like a cream or a gel or a lotion. Gels tend to be stronger and more drying than creams, so if you have oily skin, a gel might be a good idea. If you have less oily skin, then a cream would be better. Now, we all react differently to different topicals, so it's a good idea to experiment with a topical in one area before you apply it everywhere. And start with a lower strength and then ramp it up if you need more effectiveness. Now, let's say you look in the mirror, and now, by the way, is a good time to take a picture of yourself pre-treatment to use later for comparison. Let's say you see mostly red and inflamed pimples. Then you need to do something about the inflammation, which means you need to try to reduce the bacteria P. acnes. Benzoyl peroxide, or BP, is first line here, and it's available over the counter at any pharmacy. It's good to go gradual with BP, as there doesn't seem to be much difference with the different strength. I tell people to start with low strengths, like 2.5%, and start putting on for 2 hours for four nights, and for 4 hours for four nights, and then the whole night, and then wash it off in the morning. If you tolerate that well, but you want more effect, then you can try switching to a stronger version. Remember, you have to give it a few months to see if it works. All right. Back to the mirror. Looking at your face, if you see plugging on your skin, which would be small bumps, blackheads, or whiteheads, then you need to focus on unplugging. The classic unplugging agent in acne care is called a retinoid. Retinoids work by making your skin less crusty, and you need a prescription to get this treatment. Sometimes it can make your skin a bit red and dry, so again, experiment. Dryness can be helped with a moisturizer. So if you look in the mirror and see both red spots and black or whiteheads on your skin, then you need to both unplug and reduce inflammation by using a combination of both retinoid and BP. But I suggest you start with one to see how your skin reacts. There's some debate about which one should be first, but usually most people start with BP as it's over the counter. Okay, if these first line agents haven't worked, it's time to look at the next options for step-up therapy. If you're a woman, you can consider using a birth control pill as it reduces the hormones that cause plugging in the first place. This is an especially effective approach if you tend to have flare-ups of acne around your period. You can also consider a topical antibiotic to reduce P. acnes and inflammation. These can be prescribed pre-mixed with BP or a retinoid if you already know you tolerate these. Next, we often step up to antibiotics taken by mouth. Now, we do worry a bit about overusing antibiotics, so it's good to take a break every few months to see if you still need it. If your step-up therapy has not worked after all these treatments, your doctor has other options that you can discuss. Finally, if you have exhausted all your options, there is a very strong retinoid taken by mouth called isotretinoin. It is the supreme unplugger, and it's incredibly effective for severe acne. It's a bit of a mixed message here, though. Isotretinoin has some potential side effects and a powerful drying effect, so you really need to pack your lip balm and moisturizer and so on, and including the fact that it absolutely cannot be taken by a woman that is pregnant. So you need to be monitored closely when you're on this medication. Having said that, I have seen isotretinoin change the lives of more severe acne sufferers. And if you think scarring is likely, then this might be a reason to consider isotretinoin. In some sense, acne treatment is simple: reduce plugging and inflammation. But it's also complicated, as there are many, many agents that do these two things. Treating acne is a bit like basketball. You have to experiment with various players and combinations. The score can fluctuate initially, and it takes a little while to figure out who will win. But you can win if you stick with it. I've made a card to help you sort out all the different treatments. It's free at myfavoritemedicine.com. I really hope this helps. Take care.